This is the Volkswagen ID.3 Pro S, and what's special about this model is that it has a bigger 77 kilowatt hour battery. In this video, I want to find out the range in real life driving conditions. I will test the range in the city to find out the maximum range. Then I will also do a second range test on the highway to find out the minimum range. I also wanted to know how long it takes to charge the battery at a public charger. So lots of practical tests in this video. At this time, the ID.3 comes in three different battery sizes, 45 kilowatt hours, 58 and 77 kilowatt hours. This is a Pro S model, which means it has a battery with a net capacity of 77 kilowatt hours. The Pro S is an electric car that is rear-wheel drive and has a power of 204 horsepower. It has a WLTP range of up to 549 kilometers. It is highly unlikely that we will reach this number since the temperatures during our test were between 6.5 degrees and 13.5 degrees Celsius. But I'm quite curious what kind of range we will be getting in these weather conditions. Let's start the first part of the test. I will test the range at lower average speeds in the city. I want to find out what the maximum range of this car could be. Let's have a look at my results. I emptied the battery down from 89% to 62% by driving a total distance of 129 kilometers in an urban environment at lower average speeds. The temperature was between 12 and 13.5 degrees. The average consumption that I got was 15.2 kilowatt hours. The final result that I got for range at lower speeds is 507 kilometers, which is actually pretty good in these weather conditions and not that far off of the WLTP range of 549 kilometers. Let's now test the range on the highway. The goal of this part of the test is to find out the minimum range of this car by testing it at higher average speeds. For this, I will test the range mainly by driving on the highway at a constant speed of 120 kilometers per hour. Let's have a look at my results. During this part of the test, it was much colder. Temperature was between 6.5 and 9.5 degrees, and in addition to that, it was raining a lot. I emptied the battery down from 46% to 6% over a drive of 139 kilometers. The average consumption ended up to be 21 kilowatt hours, so this means the range on the highway is 367 kilometers. If you want to have an idea about the range in a more mixed scenario, the range that I got out of one battery charge from 100% to 5% was 433 kilometers, based on a consumption of 17.8 kilowatt hours and with temperatures between 6.5 and 13.5 degrees. Let's now recharge the car. As far as I can find out, the speed of the onboard AC charger is 11 kilowatt. Charging time should be around 6 to 7.5 hours. You can also do fast DC charging with a speed of up to 125 kilowatt. With DC charging, the charge level of its battery can be increased from 5 to 80% in around half an hour, enough for the next 350 kilometers, according to Volkswagen. Most of the chargers in my area are AC chargers, so I charged the car there. I charged the car from 5% to 100% in 6 hours and 40 minutes. The speed that I got was 11 kilowatt based on the 11 kilowatt onboard AC charger of the ID.3. In conclusion, I can say that the range of the Volkswagen ID.3 Pro S lies somewhere between 367 and 507 kilometers based on similar driving conditions, which is very usable for a daily driver. If the driving conditions and weather conditions change, you might get a different result. I did the same test with the Volkswagen ID.4 with a 77 kilowatt battery in the summer, and there I got a range between 397 kilometers and 558 kilometers. So my best guess is that you would get similar results with the ID.3 Pro S during the summer. I hope I was able to answer some questions you might have about this car. If you want to know more about this car, I will publish more videos, such as a full review and some point of view videos. Subscribe if you want to be notified about these future videos.